SQL Server 2019 Big Data Clusters provides compute pools to offload distributed query processing. UC is here to tell us all about us today on Data Exposed. Hi, and welcome to another episode of Data Exposed. I'm Jeroen, and today I'm joined by UC to talk about compute pools in SQL Server 2019 Big Data Clusters. Hi, UC. Thanks for joining the show again.
Sure.
So, compute pools?
Yeah.
What are they?
Yeah. So, compute pools. So, they are basically SQL Server instances in a Big Data cluster,
okay,
which can be used to offload your distributed query processing. So, in this picture, we see the many components in a SQL Server Big Data cluster. And today we're going to look at this compute pool over here.
Mm-hmm.
So what is it? It's basically a set of SQL Server instances which are automatically provisioned inside the Big Data cluster, and they are available for doing your distributed queries.
Right? Okay.
And this is similar to the Polybase scale-out groups in SQL Server 2016. And this capability now provides you out of the box a set of SQL instances which can do most of the distributed work for you.
Right? Okay.
And queries can either use the compute pool or not use the compute pool, mm-hmm, depending on the type of query.
So what kind of scenario would I choose for a compute pool?
Yeah, great question. So let's see. So one of the common scenarios is say you have two directories in HDFS with hundreds and thousands of files and you want to join them, mm-hmm, right? So in that scenario, you don't want to get all the data over to your SQL Server,
no,
which is running your application, right? So that's where the compute pool helps. So it can offload most of the work over to the HDFS,
mm-hmm,
and then later pull the necessary data to the compute pool and do the join there, right? So this basically offloads all the computing work to different SQL Server machines, which can be on different nodes in that big data cluster,
right,
and use those resources. Then the other scenario is you are joining data from different data sources,
sure,
which are partitioned differently.
Mm-hmm.
So there you have to unify that partitioning at some point, and that's where the compute pool helps.
Okay.
So if one table is distributed by customer ID and another is distributed by order ID,
mm-hmm,
and you're still joining by customer ID, it can do that reconciliation for you.
Right? Okay.
So that's some of the scenarios. And you can also do things like exporting data into HDFS, and uh-huh, that's another place where the compute pool can help.
Okay. So the compute pool will help me to parallelize, scale out my querying,
yep,
both reading from HDFS and writing to HDFS, mm-hmm, as well?
Yes.
Cool. So how does that work? I mean, can you show us a little bit of how that works?
Yeah, sure. So let's go here. Mm-hmm. I'm actually connected to a SQL Server Big Data cluster, and specifically the master instance shown here. So we now have a new DMV, which is called Compute Pools.
Okay.
And basically it shows the compute pools which are provisioned and available, mm-hmm, in the Big Data cluster. And by default, there's only one, and we show that information here. Then you can also see like how many nodes are actually there in the compute pool. And this query actually shows, apart from this particular SQL Server instance, I have two compute pool instances as shown by these highlighted rows, right?
Yeah.
And there are other DMVs which you can use to basically find information about the compute pool,
mm-hmm,
like how's the CPU activity, how much memory has been allocated, whether it's even available for the query,
right,
and so on, right? These, uh-huh, are information which DBA can use to troubleshoot compute pool.
Sure.
And additionally, you can run a complex query in SQL Server, mm-hmm, which can actually go and use the compute pool.
Okay.
So in this example, I'm joining like a local table in SQL Server with some data in HDFS, and I also have a table in Oracle which I'm querying.
Oh wow!
So you can basically run a query, and the query optimizer automatically figures out how to use the compute pool.
Mm-hmm.
In this case, it's going to use the compute pool for your HDFS table,
right?
And the rest of the data is all joined and returned. And it's an example where a compute pool transparently works to get the results for you.
Cool, that looks really good. So basically I can write this query and I can trust the compute pool will do, you know, step in where it makes sense to optimize the performance, correct?
Yes, yeah.
Awesome, exactly. Well, thanks a lot for sharing.
Sure.
So I hope this was useful. Please like and subscribe to the video and comment, and hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching.